The one thing that this test match has taught us is that, as in life, cricket teams are all about the right balance, especially if the pitches are going to be as they are, as they've been so far. Two tests against Sri Lanka, one against India, dead pitches. You have to have five bowlers. That is the crux. Now, the moment you have five bowlers, either it means that your wicketkeeper should be a proper top six batsman and seven and eight are two of your five bowlers can bat, or it means one of your top six has to give you 10-15 overs a day and your number eight has to bat. So it has enormous implications for the balance of your team. It didn't work for India, let's be honest. It didn't work for India because India's fifth bowler found that the conditions defeated him. I think he's good enough to bat in the top seven, Stuart Binney, but I don't know if the conditions are right for him, if the tracks are going to be as slow as this. So India lost out on team balance. England lost out on team balance as well because they played four bowlers, fast bowlers, but their spinner wasn't good enough. So their bowler in the top six wasn't good enough. And India's batsman in the top seven, and that didn't work either. So as the teams go to Lords, they'll be looking for one thing. They'll be looking for a surface that's a little more responsive so they can play four bowlers and just get by with somebody. That often happens in England where you play three seamers and a spinner. The spinner keeps you going. What are the top six bowls a little bit? Sourav Ganguly used to do that a fair bit for India. So that is the issue. The big plus for India though that came out of Nottingham was that the bowlers are capable of bowling long spells. Ishan Sharma flagged a bit towards the end, but he bowled 38 overs. Bhuvneshwar Kumar kept going for a long time. The only concern, I think, for India is the consistency of Mohammad Shami. And I'm sure as he bowls more, he will get that. So apart from the balance, I think both teams will look at this test match and say, we've got the big majority of our team correct. Now we just need to tinker around with the balance. But that is proving to be an issue. It was at one level a boring test match because it wasn't a contest between bat and ball for long enough, other than just two or three periods over 5 days. At another level, it was fascinating to see how, with the conditions stacked against them, the bowlers were trying to come up and do it. That is the beauty of Test cricket. But we need better wickets because my generation understands the beauty of Test cricket. The generation to come wants to see action. We can't give them a test with 29 wickets in 5 days. So we go to Lords. Beautiful weather. I've enjoyed Nottingham. Let's see if Lords is better.
If you want to stay up to date with all my video blogs, hit the subscribe button.